What's going on, everybody? It's your boy Mike Rich, man. What's happening with y'all, man? I hope everybody, each and every one of y'all, is having a blessed day today, man. Today, y'all already know what it is. It is Get 'Em or Forget 'Em for September, man. I know I'm a little late. We already a few days into September, but I still had to hit y'all with this video and tell y'all my most humble opinions on the sneakers releasing in September, man. What I want to know from y'all, I'm gonna tell y'all if I'm gonna get them or forget them, but I want to know real quick before I even start the video, if y'all familiar with these September releases, y'all tell me, is September bringing heat? Is this September 2019 bringing heat, or is they bringing that trash can water, man? Let your boy know. So let's go ahead and get into them. Let me get my phone right quick, man. Let's go ahead and get into the September releases. I'm gonna start with a couple of days ago, the Air Jordan 34. Is it the 34 now? Yes, the Air Jordan 34 got images of that shoe. Zion was rocking them, doing like through the leg dunks and stuff like that at an event. A lot of Jordan brand athletes are representing this shoe. Said we gonna rock that guy. I wonder Russell Westbrook. He's gonna probably do all kind of moves and passes and stuff like that. Get triple doubles and all kind of things in those sneakers, man. But y'all comment below and tell me what y'all think of these guys. Air Jordan 34. In my opinion, it just looked like a basketball shoe. It looked like a tech shoe. It looked like a technical basketball sneaker. A sneaker that you just basically wear on the court. It's not bad. I like the aesthetic of it. But Jordans, you know, back in the day, Jordans used to be known for... Well, they didn't. Actually, they was athletic shoes at first. But now, retro Jordans are known for casual wear. But these right here, I can't really see nobody putting on no jeans or no, you know, nothing. You know, you ain't finna go wear them out to eat. You're gonna wear them to go play some ball. So they good for that. I mean, like I said, a lot of these new Nike Tech shoes look like just that, basketball shoes, and they all kind of look similar to me. So I'm not really going crazy about it. It's like a Nike, I mean, it's a Jordan brand shoe, but it's like a Nike, any kind of Nike basketball athlete shoe. That could have been anybody's shoe. But I'm interested to see what colorways they're going to come up with. Just this past weekend, the Air Jordan 4 FIBA, never gave my opinion on this shoe. Most time, if I don't give my opinion on the shoe, either I'm waiting to see it in hand or I just flat out don't like it. This shoe right here, it ain't quite track and water. First of all, for the Jordan 34s, we're going to forget them, get them out of here. Of course, I ain't going to get that shoe. But these right here, these FIBA 4s, they not track and water. They're not quite track and water. But they just... I just ain't really gotta have a shoe, man. That's just a shoe that it's all red. It got hits of blue and white. Yeah. Red, white, and blue sneaker. Tumble leather. Got your little graphics on the side. Gold Jumpman in the back. It like an Olympic shoe. It looked like an Olympic Jordan 4 that would have came out back in the day. But I don't know, man. It's just nothing. For some reason, there's nothing about that shoe. I love Jordan 4s, but it's nothing about that shoe just saying, you gotta have them. You gotta cop these. I mean, even if they go to the outlet, it just don't seem like a shoe that I really just need to have in my collection. Yeah, man. So for the Air Jordan 4 FIBA, I'm sorry to say it's gonna be a forget them. No disrespect or no hate to the people who went out and cop. I know every time you say you don't like some people say you hating on them. Why is that the new thing? Every time you don't like a shoe, people say you hating. I'm not hating on it. It just ain't for me. I don't like it. It's my humble opinion. You feel me? Sometimes when people give their humble opinion, it don't sound too humble. So that's probably why people think it's hate. It's just like, I'm not going to buy that shoe. It ain't for me. You feel me? So anyway, next up, and I'm not going to talk about every shoe because there's so many sneakers releasing that I really could just care less about. I'm just going to, you know, talk about some shoes that kind of stand out. I mean, not necessarily shoes that I want, but shoes that just... I feel like y'all would be interested in. So next up, we got the, I don't even want to talk about Yeezy. I already talked about Yeezy 700 V2 Inertia. I already talked about that shoe in a video before because it had a release date that was supposed to be a little earlier. So in one of my earlier videos, I talked about this shoe, so I ain't going to go crazy about it. I'm not really feeling them. I think the Wave Runner is the only colorway in that shoe that I ever would consider wearing, I guess. But still, the retail price of $300, man, these things... The retail is basically a resale price. You feel me? So I'm good on those. Next, I think these released Super Bowl. Not Super Bowl. I think these released Sunday. The first NFL Sunday, I think they released. I think they did. They're Nike Air Max 720 OBJ. The Odell guys, Young King of the People. So that should release. It looks a little bit better than the first colorway. It looks more wearable, let's put it that way. It looked like you can rock that thing and put it together with some fits. The other one just had a lot of crazy colors going on with it, but I'm not really a fan of any of these 720 sneakers with air bubble going all the way around. Just not something I'm crazy. I'm not just a fan of that big, swollen air bubble look like it been stung by a bee. I just ain't a fan of that. Just not for your boy, man. So let's go ahead and go past that one. That was a get 'em. I mean, forget 'em. Get 'em out of here. Forget 'em. You feel me? Then we got another one. Like I said, I don't like doing these Yeezys because the release dates change so much that I don't like doing them. I'm just going to talk about it real quick. The Adidas Yeezy Boost 700 Magnet colorway. I actually like this colorway. It kind of reminds me of the Wave Runner colorway. Still won't be a cop for you, boy. Just not interested in the 700s like that, man. Just my humble opinion. But I do like the colorway on these, man. I like they got like some kind of black, gray, and then it got hints of like orange, and it got like the gum bottoms, man. So I think it's a dope shoe, especially if you're in the Yeezys. And a lot of these shoes, when you see them on feet, the Yeezys, man, they look dope on feet. So y'all copping, y'all let me know. But as for your boy, forget them, get them on out of here. So next up, we got the Nike Sakai Waffle Pine Green colorway, and we got a black colorway coming out as well. I think it's like two more colorways coming out, so like a white one or something like that. Anyway, the Sakai Waffles are straight. I actually like the original colorways better. That green one, that first one that released when they had the blue one and the green one, that's probably like the only one up until this point as far as all the colorways I'm seeing that I would cop. These are straight, man. I heard these shoes weren't that comfortable though. Heard it like you're walking on some bricks, you're walking on some, I feel like I've heard more than one person say, this shoe ain't that comfortable, but you know, so I haven't had a chance to try them on because they limited. And like, you can just walk in the Foot Locker and be like, hey man, let me get that Shy 12 and see what them things feel like. You can't do it with these, man. So I might go after a pair. Maybe, I don't know, but you know what I'm saying? I don't know if they're gonna be as limited as the first one since they got a lot of colorways coming out. Y'all comment below and tell me what y'all think of those. But for now, what I'm gonna say right now is a forget them. I'm not really gonna go crazy trying to get them, so forget them. Get them on out of here. You feel me? So, next up, we got, where we at? I'm going to skip past all. Okay, next up, arguably the best release in September. It is to me as well. I love Jordan 6s, and I really am digging the Air Jordan 6 Travis Scott's. Boom! Olive guys, love the orange hits. I did a whole video about this shoe too, about how hard it's going to be to get. I don't know though, because now they're saying they're releasing in family sizes. And a lot of times when the shoe is releasing in the family, full family size runs, that means they're making a little bit more for the people. So it might be a chance, a better chance to get those than these Travis Scott ones. Because I don't know if I'm mistaken or not, but the Travis Scott one highs and lows, neither one of those came in full family sizes. I don't think they did. I think they was just super limited sneakers. So if these come in full family sizes, I think it might be a better chance to get them. I can't remember if those back there, the Travis Scott 4s, I can't remember if they came in full family sizes, but it was more of these out there than any other Travis Scott so far, man. So, like I said, I did a whole, if you want to know my real opinion, going through detail, I did a whole video about this shoe when they first announced the release date being on September 14th. So, comment below if you're going after them. Most of y'all, out of any shoe on this list, y'all probably going after Travis Scott 6s. I'm not out there buying the cereal boxes and all that stuff because I'm like, It really ain't that serious to you, boy. Like, they have the cereal boxes, man. I like shoes. If I get the cereal boxes, think about it, people save them. I mess around and eat the cereal, man. I like Reese's Puffs, they be here. But I'm definitely going after these. So my first get them in the video is the Air Jordan 6 Travis Scott Medium Olive. They dope, man. They just dope. Next up, we got a shoe that I probably won't be able to get anyway, and that's the Air Jordan 4 Women's Mushroom. I like the colorway on this shoe. Women, they get dope colorways, man. I like them. They're nice. They look better than the FIBA joints. I would rock these over the FIBAs. I like the materials. It look like it's some kind of suede or something going on these guys. I really would rock them if they came my size. I don't necessarily know if I would buy them. Seems like another shoe I'll probably wait around to see if it go on sale, see if I can get it for their discount, that outlet special, you know what I'm talking about? So, you know, of course, get them, forget them, get them out of here because I can't wear them. Anyway, next up is the Air Jordan 3 Knicks. It says Knicks Rivals. So it's like, I guess it's like based on Michael Jordan going down to Madison Square Garden and just scoring 55 points and doing all this crazy stuff to the New York Knicks. I really like the colorway. I really like the shoe. And to be honest with you, probably 2 or 3 years ago, I would have these already. I would have these in hand showing y'all that early review, that early look. But I honestly, and I think, like, just like me and my wife talked about on the video about me getting on YouTube and getting sneakers, that I would probably buy, but sneakers that I probably wouldn't buy if I went on YouTube. And it's like, you would like a sneaker, but you'd be like, bro, I ain't gotta have that. But when you're on YouTube and you're gonna put a video, you're like, well, that's a dope sneaker. I would definitely rock it, so I'm gonna get it. And the bonus is I'm gonna get to do a video and show y'all the shoe early and all that stuff. So I probably would've did that. Cause the plug, my plugs and stuff, they've been had this sneaker right here. I probably would've did that, but I don't even know if I'm a cop at all. Unless I can get them for like under retail or something like that. So I like the shoe. I like the colorway. It's a Jordan 3. I have nothing negative to say about this shoe, man. I like it. I'm just probably not going to copy it. You feel me? So the only negative thing I'm going to say is forget them. Get them out of here. Tentatively for now. We're going to say forget them. Get them out of here. So next up, they not done with Yeezy Boost 350. This is the Cloud White colorway. They got a reflective and a non-reflective. I'm going to go over that real quick. Forget them. Get them on out of here. Just, I'm over it, man. I'm completely over the 350. And they got another one called the V2 Citroen Reflective. So, I guess that's what they're doing now. They're still bringing out Yeezy 350 V2s. I guess that's what they're doing, man. So, you know. Forget them, get them out of here. I'm good. Y'all comment below if y'all still on the V2 350 train. Your boy, you know, never really been crazy about them. So they make so many of them, bro. Like they make some. I commented that in the video. I said they make so many of these shoes. They ain't done with it yet. And of course, I had like one person in the comments saying, "Man, you ain't gotta like them. The V2s are fire, man. They don't need to stop making them. You don't say that when they make all these Jordan 1s." And I'm like, bro. I ain't even respond, but I'm going to respond now, bro. Don't ever in your life compare the Air Jordan 1 OG High to a Yeezy V2 350 for real with all the history in 1985, man. And this man doing all this stuff in the league. You feel me? Michael Jordan. From this box right here. From this box. From the day when you had the black and red Nike box, man, for the J's, all the way up until now, you comparing that shoe? You comparing that shoe? Man, bro. Yeezy 350 V2, I'm gonna go ahead and say it. No, I ain't gonna say it's track. I'm gonna say it's track and water. It's not track and water, because I see it on certain people's feet. It look smaller feet. The shoe look clean, man, but you can never compare it to Air Jordan 1, man, so don't do that. Don't do that, man. Don't do that. Man, my stomach hurt, man. Don't do that. anyway, man, next up we got the... Oh, so let's forget them on all the Yeezy, man. Forget them. Air Jordan 1, OG High. Speaking of Jordan 1s, and I hate to follow it with this shoe because I don't like it. First Class is the yellow, white, yellow, and it got that kind of cracked looking leather on it. Got a barcode on the back. Look like it's, I don't know, man. I think these look, trash can water, man. I hate to say it, man. These trash can water. I'm not feeling them, bro. I'm not feeling them, man. Like, you get to the point where there's a lot of dope Jordan 1 colorways come out. You be like, man, that's fire. They coming out with some dope stuff. And then you get stuff like this. A lot of people like this shoe. Don't get me wrong. So I know I might get a little heat on this. A lot of people like this shoe, but I'm passing, man. Forget them. Get them on out of here. It ain't nothing about that shoe that I like, man. It's different, but it's different. Don't necessarily mean better, man. So, it's some Adidas stuff coming out. I know I'm skimming over some stuff, man. Some Night Jogger. Got some Pumas, got some Zoom Greek, the Freak Greek, whatever your name is. Okay, and this is arguably the second best release behind the Travis Scott Air Jordan 6, and it's the Air Jordan 12 Game Royal, which a lot of people are calling Blue Games, because it's like the opposite of the Flu Game. It's just blue instead of red. It's just like a Flu Game. It's just blue instead of red. I like the shoe. It's dope. When I first seen images of it, I think me and Tony D did a release video for like upcoming 2019 releases. And I said I was going after Tony D. I wonder if Tony D changed his energy. Tony D, if you're watching this video, did you change your energy? Do you still not like this? Because I remember him saying he didn't like them and he went feeling the blue and black. And I, from day one, I've been saying these are fire. Cop, get them, get them, get them. Air Jordan 12, Game Royal. Blue Game. I don't really like the Blue Game, man. I think it's just too gimmicky, too on the nose. Nah, bro. Blue Game, nah, we can't do that. But Game Royal, they fresh, they cleansed. Hopefully I have a pair in my collection. I think I will. I think I wouldn't have a problem. Seems like they might be a pretty general release. Only thing I don't know is what size to go with, because my Flu Game 12s and my Taxi 12s, all of them run like a half size too big. But then like the more recent Jordan 12 releases, like these International 12s, and what else? These, what you call them? Bordeaux 12s right here. And those fit perfect. But then you got my Flint 12s. Like I said, all the rest of them that came out like in 2000, whatever, 16 that was, all of them fit like a half size too big. So I don't know what size to get. Hopefully I'll be able to try them on before I cop them. I don't know though, because a lot of people, especially in Atlanta, they go crazy over 12s. And people go crazy over a black and whatever colorway shoe, black and red, black and whatever, black and orange. People go crazy over those colorways. It's probably a black and yellow one coming out too. It might be next year. And I think it's only a matter of time before they do like a black and orange, like a Shattered Backboard kind of joint 12. So y'all comment below and tell what y'all think of those. But those are a get them. So two get them's, Travis Scott 6s, if I can get those. And then these Air Jordan 12 Game Royals, man. So last but not least, I had to end it on the Yeezy. I wasn't even going to talk about this, but this colorway is actually fine. Like I said, Mike definitely not cop this shoe, so I'm gonna go ahead and say forget them off rip. But the Adidas Yeezy Boost 700 teal blue, I know I just got on the 350 V2s, but these 700s right here, like I said, they doing some dope colorways with this shoe, man. They got the teal blue hits, they got the gray, they got the gum bottoms, and they got the orange laces, and which really makes the shoe pop. Two different kind of grays on the shoe. Like I said, as time go by, I really starting to like these a little bit, but they just gotta come some. Like the Wave Runner was like the best colorway, but this one right here is dope. I seen it on feet, some on feet pics of it already. It's a fast shoe. Like I said, probably not gonna get it, but I really do dig the colorway. So that's it, man. The next up shoes is gonna be like October stuff, and I'm not gonna get into that because I gotta do a get them or forget them for October as well, man. So with that being said, I appreciate y'all for watching this video, man. Y'all comment below and let me know what y'all going after in the month of September 2019, man. I appreciate y'all for watching it. I only had two get them's, but that might change because as the month goes along, they might have some pop-up releases. A lot of times when I do these get them or forget them sneaker releases, videos, they'll come up with another shoe that I just completely missed. And speaking of that, if y'all think it's a shoe I should have talked about on this video, comment below and let me know. And as always, I appreciate y'all for watching. Hit the thumbs up, like, subscribe to my channel if you haven't done so already. Hit that notification bell so you can become a part of Rich Nation, staying all the way up to the moon on them, on the way, on the road to 300K. And keep watching my video, because that's what I'm here for. Just kicks, Jordan 6, 8 and 9 fit, hottest, trends, clank, clank, cleanse, bless, yes, I'm rich.